Hello everyone. So in last lecture we have seen strain energy due to strain energy stresses due to various types of axial loads. Okay. So first we have seen gradually applied load, then suddenly applied load, and then impact load. So we are now seeing impact load. The stresses produced due to impact loading are much higher than that of gradual and sudden loading. So examples are dynamic loads. So when in a rod, vertical rod, sudden the impact of load is acting, then this is called as impact load or dynamic load. Consider load P dropped from height h and extension produced is delta L. So let sigma maximum sigma is the maximum intensity of stress produced. Therefore, extension of bar is delta N is equal to P upon capital V into small L. Equating loss of potential energy to strain energy stored by the rod. So equating these two energy, we will get the loss of potential energy will be force, that is P into height, change in height, that is H plus delta L. And strain energy stored is sigma square upon 2e into volume, that is a into n. So as delta L is p by e into l, so this equation becomes like this, that is p into h plus delta l h plus sigma l upon e bracket complete is equal to sigma square upon 2e into volume. So after solving this equation, we will get this quadratic equation. So after solving this equation, that is C sigma square minus 2p sigma upon h is equal to 2p sigma e upon al, adding sigma square upon s square on both sides of this equation, we will get. So we have to solve this equation to get value of sigma. So this is the final equation, that is in bracket sigma minus p upon a, the bracket complete square, is equal to p upon p square upon a square plus p plus 2p h e upon a is the final equation for impact loading. So if numerical are come to exam on this type of loading, then use this formula. Now we will see next point, strain energy stored due to bending. See, this is a uniformly distributed load acting on a fixed support, and this is a total fixed support. Okay, so acting on fixed support on a beam, suppose we have taken two sections, section 1 and section 2, apart from distance dl. Okay, total length is delta small l. Okay, if member of length l and sectional area a is subjected to axial force s, then strain energy stored is s is equal to sigma square upon 2e into volume. Okay, strain energy stored is sigma square upon 2e into volume. So here as sigma is stress, so it is equal to axial force upon area, that is S upon A. Okay, so 1 upon 2E, rewrite this equation, 1 upon 2E in bracket S upon A square into volume, that is A into A. So S square L upon 2A. Consider section 1-1 and 2-2, dx apart, distance dx apart, bending moment practically constant across section. Let the bending moment is capital A. The stress in the length of the cylinder is sigma is equal to m upon I into y, as I is the moment of inertia about neutral axis, and you know that this is the basic formula for sigma, the stress and bending moment. So sigma is stress, bending m is bending moment, I is moment of inertia about neutral axis, and small y is the deflection. So strain energy stored by elementary cylinder is sigma square upon 2e into volume of elementary cylinder. area vector change at volume. Volume is the area into length. That is, here area is dA. Suppose area is dA, that is small elemental area, and distance is dx. So, and sigma is the m over I into y. So put this value in here, sigma, and we will get the equation like this. That in bracket m upon I into y whole square into d into dx upon 2d. So equation will be become m square dx upon 2e I square in bracket d into y square. As per definition of moment of inertia, we know that the y square into da is the integration of y square into da is the moment of inertia. So see, this is the strain energy stored by elemental cylinder. Elemental cylinder means a small element of section of volumes, cylindrical volume. So strain energy stored in that small section will be like this. So we will get total strain energy stored in a cylindrical beam will be equal to the integration of or summation of that equation. So strain energy stored by dx length of the beam is equal to strain energy stored by all elemental cylinder between the two sections. So it is equal to m square dx upon 2e I square sum of dA into y square. As summation of dA into y square is the capital I, that is moment of inertia. So m square dx upon 2e I square into I is equal to m square dx upon 2e I. So this is the energy stored by dx length of the beam. Therefore strain energy stored by whole beam is Wi is equal to integration of m square dx upon 2er, that is integration of this part. Now we see next point, that is strain energy stored in torsion. The torsional strain energy in shaft is equal to work done in twisting. So the torsional strain energy in the shaft is equal to work done in twisting, which is equal to u is equal to 1 by 2 t into theta, that is t is the torque of that and theta is angle of twisting. So torsional strain energy is 1 by 2 torque into angle of twisting. Due to torque, shear stresses are developed in metal, hence strain energy upon volume is tau square upon 2d. Consider elemental tube of radius r, thickness dr and length l. Volume will be dv is equal to 2 pi r dr into l. Okay, this is the volume of elemental volume of a tube. So strain energy stored in elemental volume dv is du is equal to, that is elemental strain energy is equal to tau square upon 2g into dv. Tau square upon 2g into 2 pi r dr into l. So after integrating, we will get the total strain energy due to torsion. Integrate from 0 to r, or a radius 0 to r, we will get tau square upon 2g 2 pi r dr into l. From torsion formula, tau upon r is equal to t upon ip. Ip is the, where ip is Poisson moment of inertia, t is the torque and tau is the torsional stress. Therefore tau is T upon IP into R. So strain energy is equal to U is equal to integrating from 0 to R. Integrate this total, that is sigma, the value of tau is T upon IP into R. Okay. So in bracket T upon IP into R whole square into upon 2G here. And then 2 pi r upon t 2g into l into dr. So 2 gets cancelled here. Put all constant value outside of the integration. So t square l square pi upon 2g ip square is the constant value. Put it outside of the integration and only integrate the value which is variable. here the value, variable value is r square into r, r square into r, that is r cube. So integrate r cube into dr. After integrating r cube, we will get integration of r cube is r raised to 4 upon 4. So constant value into r raised to 4 upon 4. Now T square L I P upon 2 G I P square is the total scale energy produced in the elemental cylinder, okay, due to torsion. In next lecture we will see module number 5, that is columns.